Dear students, the topic of this lecture is the determination of ground state term symbols for transition metal complexes. So, for transition metal complexes, the term symbols are known as Mulliken terms, that are molecular terms. Atomic terms we have already discussed in the previous lecture. So, in this lecture, we will try to calculate the ground state term for transition metal complexes that will be very useful to draw or to plot the Tanabe-Sugano diagrams. So we can easily understand the Tanabe-Sugano diagrams, and their ground state term can be easily calculated. So to find out the ground state terms for transition metal complexes, we have to first study about the direct product table of octahedral point groups. The Tanabe-Sugano diagrams are very useful for octahedral complexes, because in case of octahedral complexes, there are two types of complexes, weak field as well as strong field complexes. So these terms, generally they are derived from this group theory. So symmetry and group theory arguments, they are helpful in determining the ground state term of octahedral transition metal complexes. So first we have to learn about the product table of octahedral groups. So this is the product table. We can see that we have formed a table that is containing some terms A1, A2, E, T1, T2 and in this column, and in this row there are the five terms A1, A2, E, T1 and T2. So we will find out the products. This is according to the group theory. So if we'll find the products A1 when multiplied with the A1, it will results A1 with A2. This is like an Excel sheet. So this is a cell. This is a cell. So this cell is the product of this into this. This is the product of this into this. So we can see that if A1 multiply with A1, then it produces A1. So A1 when it reacts with or it crossed with A2, then it will generate A2 term. So A1 whenever it cross with the other term, then it will generate the similar term. So with A1 with E, it results E. With T1, it results T1. With T2, it results T2. In case of A2, we can see that in case of A2, it will revert. So if A2 react with it, if A2 multiply with A1, the product will be A1. With A2, it gives A1. With E, E is identity types. It always gives the product E. And then T1, when cross with A2, it form T2. So T1 into T2 and T2 into T1. So with A1, that will remain the same. With A1, T2 remains the T2, but with A2, it will convert into T1. Now, we will study about the description of these terms. What do we mean by A? What is meant by E? What is T? We will discuss later on. So, A means, A is singly degenerate state. Capital A means it is a state. So it is singly degenerate state, A1 or A2. E means doubly degenerate. This is doubly degenerate state, like EG orbital. EG is doubly degenerate. It is having two orbitals, dx square, y square and dz square. So that is small e, but it is E, capital E is capital E. So it is a state, it is a term. So it is doubly degenerate term. Then come to T1 and T2. T means triply. So as we write T2G for orbital, that is D orbital that contain dxy, dyz and dzx orbitals, that is triply degenerate. So similarly for the state which is triply degenerate, we denote it by T. So these are T. So if we multiply this A with A, it will generate a single term. A is singly degenerate and A is singly degenerate. So 1 into 1 is equal to 1. The product will also be 1. So if A1 crossed with A2, then the product will always be 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. So in case of A into E, AE is doubly degenerate, it is 2. Its degeneracy is 2. When 2 multiplied by with 1, so it gives the product will be 2. So this is triply degenerate, it is 3. Its degeneracy is 3. So if we multiply this with singly degenerate, so it will result in the formation of a triply degenerate state. 3. The product will be 3. So likewise, T2 and A1, the product will be 3. So this is the basic concept. Then if we see the E, so if E reacts with A, then it will result in 2. Doubly degenerate, singly degenerate. So again the state will be E. But if we multiply E with E, this is also 2 and this is also 2. So 2 into 2 is equal to 4. So these two, when multiplied with these two states, then the multiplicity will become 4. So 4. If we see this product, this is A1 plus A2 plus E. So this is the cross product of E and E. Multiplicity becomes 1. Its degeneracy become A1, 1 degeneracy, 1 degeneracy and 2 degeneracy. So total is 4. So its total is 4. So if we multiply this E with E, we will get 3 terms. This is according to group theory, A1, A2 and E. In which A2 is, this is antisymmetric state. So in case of when we multiply T with E, its degeneracy is 3 and its degeneracy is 2. So 3 into 2 is equal to 6. So total degeneracy will be 2. This is 6. So T1 plus T2, it is 3, have 3 degeneracy, it is also 3 degeneracy. So total is 6. So when E multiply with T, it will give 6 degeneracy terms. Likewise, when it multiply with T2, so it again gives rise to 2 terms and total degeneracy will be 6. Now, when this T1 multiply with the T1, its degeneracy is 3, its degeneracy is also 3. So they will generate, the total degeneracy become 9. So we can calculate this T1, 3, 3, 2, 1. So total degeneracy is 9. So terms generated from product of E and T1 and T1 is A1 plus E plus T1 plus T2. So these are the terms with the 9 degeneracy. So these are Mulliken terms. Then if we see the cross product of T1 and T2, then we can see this A2, here A1, here A2, but the total degeneracy will remain the 9. So this is a short table which is generated from the group theory. So if we remind it in our mind, then we can, it is helpful in determining the ground state term symbols for the transition metal complexes. So we have to remember that if A1 state multiply with any state, then it will generate that state. Then when A2 multiply with other states, it changed the state. So if it is multiplied with A2, it converts into A1. If it is multiplied with T1, it converts into T2. And we have to remember that E into E is the product is A1 plus A2 plus E. And when T and T multiplied, they will generate 9 degeneracy terms, that is A, E, T1 and T2. So we will try to short out the calculations regarding ground state term symbols for transition metal complexes. So, dear students, before going to for the calculations of ground state term symbols for transition metal complexes, I would like to explain these terms. So, A is singly degenerate, E means doubly degenerate, and T means triply degenerate. And we can explain with the help of these examples what do we mean by A state. So, A state, if the ground state or excited state, this is the ground state. So if this state is having only one degeneracy, these electrons can be arranged only by one mean. This is only one way to arrange these 3 electrons. In this case, there are 5 electrons and we can arrange these electrons only once. Likewise, these are full-filled orbitals, and this is the only arrangement of electrons in this orbital. And in case of here also, there is only one way of representation of these electrons. So this state is known as A state because it has single degeneracy. No other way to present this electronic configuration. So this state is known as A state, singly degenerate. Only one possibility of electronic arrangement. So if the electronic configuration is half filled, but it is T2G set. If it is T2G set is half filled, or EG and T2G set are half filled, or both are full filled, or T2G is completely filled, then these terms are known as A. They have only one way to represent their electronic configuration. In case of E state, and now in this example, we can see that this is a high D4 high spin complex. So we can see that in this case, E is doubly degenerate. E is asymmetrically filled. So only one electron is there. This electron may be here or may be here. So if this electron is here, then this is the one possibility, and other possibility is it may be here. So it has two possibility. Likewise here, in this case, this is D9 configuration. So in case of D9 configuration, this electron pair may be here or this electron pair may be here. So there is possibility, two possibilities of arranging these electrons. In this case also, it is D7 configuration, and in this case also, this electron, single electron, can be here or can be here. So it is doubly degenerate condition. So this electron may be here or may be here. So this is doubly degenerate condition. So if EG set is asymmetrically filled like this, asymmetrically filled, one electron or three electron or one electron, then the generated state is E. Then we called it as E. Now the third possibility is that there are two electrons. So these two electrons may be here or may be here. There are three possibilities of arranging these two electrons when they are present in T2G set. Likewise here, this is one electron, it is present in T2G set. So it can be here, it can be here, or it can be here. So there are three possibilities. In this case, this single electron may be here, or may be here. So there are again three possibilities. So in case of any electronic configuration where the T2G set is asymmetrically filled, there is possibility of arranging these electrons in three possible ways. So this is triply degenerate because they have three possibilities. So these are triply degenerate states. So we can say, according to electronic configuration, we can also decide about the states or the term symbols. These are, if we can arrange the electrons only by one way, then it is A state. Or if we arrange there by two ways, that means E is asymmetrically filled, then E state. And if we can arrange the three possibilities of electrons, so it is T state. And this occurs when T2G set is asymmetrically filled. Now, first we will take the configurations that have similar electronic arrangement in high spin as well as low spin complexes. So in case of D1, D2, D3, D8 and D9, these are five configurations in which low spin and high spin complexes, they are similar. So in case of D1 configuration, if we see the D1 configuration, then we will find that this electron is present in T2D set. So this T2G set electron, it has been found to be, because it is triply degenerate condition. So one electron may be here, may be here, may be here. So this state is T. We can easily decide then this state is T, that is triply degenerate, because this T2G set is asymmetrically filled. And this condition, you have to remember some points, that this condition, when only one electron is there, then this state is T2G. This state is T2G. It is T because it is triply degenerate, and it is T2G when one electron is present. You have to remember two points. So it is T2G. Y2, this 2 means multiplicity. Multiplicity is 2s plus 1. So because we have only one electron means spin is half. So 2 into half plus 1 is equal to 2. So this is the multiplicity. So 2t2g will be the ground state term symbol for d1 configuration. Either this is high spin or low spin. That will remain the same. So for d2 configuration, the electronic arrangement is like this. So here 2 electrons are unpaired. And this is again the asymmetric condition of filling of t2g set. So these 2 electrons may be here, one may be here, one may be here, and third one is one may here and one may here. So there it is triply degenerate state. So term will be t, the generatic term will be t, triply degenerate, because t2g is asymmetrically filled. So why this 3? 3 is because of these 2 unpaired electrons. So plus half plus half, so total spin becomes 1. And 2s plus 1 is equals to 3. So multiplicity is 3. So if we have to again remember that if there are 2 electrons in T2G set, then this is known as T1G. It is T1G state. So we have to remember 2 things. If 1 electron is there in T2G set, then it is T2G. And if 2 electrons are there, then if it is T1G. This multiplicity can be easily calculated. So this T1G and T2G, it is based on this symmetry group theory. Then we go to the D3 configuration. So in case of D3 configuration, there is only one possibility. There is no possibility to arrange these 3 electrons when they are present in different orbitals. These are unpaired electrons. So there is only one possibility. So it is A term, singly degenerate. So this is singly degenerate. So it will generate a term that is A. Singly degenerate term. So, and why 4? Because there are 3 unpaired electrons, plus half, plus half, plus half. So, total spin becomes 3 by 2. And 3 by 2 into 2 plus 1 is equal to 4. So, multiplicity becomes 4. Multiplicity is 2s plus 1. So, this term is A2G. A2G because this is not completely half filled. If this and this, they also have single electrons, then the term will be symmetric term. Then it can be called as A1. But if it is only the T2G set is half filled, so this term is known as A2G. So you have to remember three points, that if one electron is there in T2G set, then it is T2G. If 2 electrons are there, so it is T1G. And if only T2G set is half filled or completely filled, then the term will be A2G. So it is 4A2G. Now come to the other configurations, D8 configuration. Now we can use that multiplication table again. You can check from the multiplication table. So in case of D8 configuration, we can define this configuration as D3 plus D5. We can write this as D3 plus D5. Total electrons are 8. So 1, 2, 3. 3 and 5 are filled. So we can write like this. So if we see in case of D3 configuration, the term is A2G. So A2G multiply with, now there are D5 configuration, 1, 2, 3. If we, I will show this with red. So this is D3 and remaining blue are D5. So in case of D5, these are symmetrically filled, 1, 2, 3, half filled. It is also half filled. So this type of state is called as A1G. D3 is A2G because it is not completely symmetric, so it is A2G. And D5 is completely symmetric, so it is A1G. So it is the multiplication, it is the summation of D3 and D5 configuration. So it comes to the A2G multiplied by A1G. And we know that if we multiply A1G to any other state, then the product will be A2G. So this state is A2G. So we can write this is A2G And what will be the multiplicity? Because there are two unpaired electrons, so total spin is equal to 1. So 2s plus 1 is equal to 3. So this is 3a2g. So thus this term is 3a2g. Now we can go to this D9 configuration. So in case of D9 configuration, we can see easily that here E term, E G set is asymmetrically filled. So this term is definitely, this term is EG. This is EG, this is doubly degenerate, this pair may be here or this may be here. So this is doubly degenerate term. So it is EG, but what EG? Because there is only one unpaired electron, so S is equal to half. So 2S plus 1 is equal to 2. So it is 2EG. So the ground state term will be 2EG. So if in case of D9 configuration, this is 2EG. So if we summarize this these configurations, so we will find that in case of D1 configuration, the ground state term is T2G. This is D1G. Then for D3 it is A2G. For D8 it is A2G again, and for D9 configuration it is 2EG. Now in case of four configurations, that are D4, D5, D6 and D7. These are four configurations which have different electronic arrangement in high spin and low spin complexes. So we have to write the different configurations in the different columns, and then we have to evaluate the ground state term symbols for high spin as well as low spin complexes. So now we can see that in case of D4 configuration, we can easily find out the ground state term symbol, because here EG set is asymmetrically filled. So if EG set is asymmetrically filled, this is high spin, D4 high spin configuration. So if EG is asymmetrically filled, means it may be here, it may be here. So there are two possibilities. Two possibilities means the term will be E. The generating term will be EG. Why 5? Because there are four unpaired electrons, and these unpaired electrons, their total spin becomes 2, and multiplicity will become 2s plus 1 is equal to 5. So the ground state term will become 5eg. In case of D5 configuration, which is this is the configuration, we can see easily that all the T2g and eg set, they are symmetrically filled. So this is symmetrically filled configuration. So in this case, this term is known as A1. When all are symmetrically filled, then this term is known as A1. So this is A1G term. A1 means totally symmetric. So if electrons are not there, only here, then it is A2G. But if all are symmetrically filled, then the term is A1G. And why 6? Because there are 5 unpaired electrons, and the S will become 5/2, and this multiplicity becomes 6. So the ground state term will be A1G. Then in case of D6 configuration, now in case of D6 configuration, we can make it as a summation of D1 configuration and D5 configuration. So this is D1. So if we see one electron, it is of D1, and rest is D5 configuration. So in case of D5 configuration, D5 is A1G. So D5 is A1G, and D1 configuration is, we have already completed that D1 configuration, that has T2G state. So this is the combination of D1 and D5, and it is the multiplication of A1G and T2G. So A1G and T2G, when multiplied by each other, so they will generate the term T2G. So the generated term will be T2G, because A1, when multiplied with any term, that will generate the same term. So the ground state term will be 5T2G, 5, because there are 4 unpaired electrons. So the total spin becomes 2, and this will become 5. Now in case of D7 configuration, we can see that this is a combination of, this may be defined as the combination of D2 and D5 configuration. So it is a combination of D2 and D5 configuration, and the ground state term for D2 we have already discussed. For D2 it is T
T1G. So for D2 it is T1G and for D5 it is A1G. For D5 is it A1G and for D2 it is T1G. So T1G into A1G. So when A1G multiplied by any terms, then it will generate the same term. So it will generate T1G. And it has 3 unpaired electrons. So multiplicity become 4. And the term become 4T1G. So you have to remember only 3 things. That is about D1 configuration, D2 configuration and D3 configuration. If we know these 3 terms and if we know the direct product table of octahedral point groups, then we can easily calculate the term symbols, the ground state term symbols for this octahedral complexes. Now, in case of low spin complexes, we can again see that in case of D4 configuration, the arrangement will like this. So, in this case, we can see that this is the product of, this can be the direct product of D1 and D3 configuration. So D1 we have already determined, that is T2G, ground state term symbol for D1 is T2G and for D3 it is A2G. So when A2G is multiplied by with any term, that will change. We can see in this table that when this A2G term, when this A2 term multiply with T1, it becomes T2, or with T1 it becomes T2. So in case here also, when T2G multiply by with A2G, it becomes T1G. So it has 2 unpaired electrons, so multiplicity becomes 3 and the term becomes 3T1G. Then D5 configuration in low spin complex, we can see this is the product of D2 and D3 configuration. So in case of D2, the ground state term is T1G, we have already discussed, and then D3 is A2G. So when we multiply T1G into A2G, so A2G with, when T1G multiplied with A2G, it becomes T2. So it becomes T2G, single electron, half spin, so multiplicity will be 2. So this term will be 2T2G. Then we can discuss about the ground state term symbol for D6 configuration, low spin, in low spin complexes. So these are all paired, and in this case, this paired also, it is also a symmetric type. According to group theory, this is a symmetric type arrangement. So this term is also known as A1G. The symmetric type arrangement, or either they are all are half filled, or this T2G is fully filled, then it is A1G. And there are no unpaired electrons. So S is equal to 0. So multiplicity 2S plus 1 is equal to 1. So the term becomes 1A1G. So this point should also be remembered, that if D2G set is fully filled and there are no electrons in AG set, then the ground state term will be A1G. This will be very useful in your Tenobo-Sugano diagram. I will discuss later the Tenobo-Sugano diagram. In case of D7 configuration, low spin complexes, again we can see that it is a combination, it is not just a combination, but you can see that this AG set is asymmetrically filled. So if this AG set is asymmetrically filled, then it is doubly degenerate. This electron may be here or may be here. So this is E state. So it is EG because of one paired unpaired electron. It becomes, the multiplicity becomes 2. So we can easily determine the ground state term symbols for any transition metal complex. These are octahedral complexes. For octahedral complexes, because in orbital diagrams we have read only about this high spin complexes or weak field complexes, but for Tenobo-Sugano diagrams it is necessary to learn about the ground state term determination of low spin complexes as well, because Tenobo-Sugano diagrams, they are applicable for both type of complexes. And for drawing the Tenobo-Sugano diagram, it is necessary to determine or to calculate the ground state term symbols, so that we have not to just remember, but we have to conceptually determine, conceptually we have to put in our mind that what will be the ground state term of the low spin complexes.
Thank you very much. And if you like this video, you can like, subscribe.